the topic a little bit here, because we're talking about these cross influences. It seems to me these days, not only in music but in all the arts, but especially in music, there's so much cross influence with all kinds of ethnic musics, mm-hmm. world music. What do you think about the role of Chinese music in all of this? Is Chinese music becoming melding with world music in a similar way? Because I don't know that much about. I haven't heard that much, you know, Chinese mm-hmm. like what you're doing.
Mm-hmm.
I've heard a lot more of other kinds of, you know, certainly we know of Cuba, Africa, Brazil,
India.
Yeah. All these things are just meshing together, mm-hmm. you know, with electronic sounds, with all kinds of things.
Yeah.
What about Chinese music? Is it also, you know, a part of all of this? Or is it still a little bit marginalized? Are you kind of an exception, or are you becoming the rule?
For my own experience, of course, is very different, because I've collaborated with many, many different world musicians,
yeah.
All over the world. But from the bigger picture,
yeah.
of the whole, see how much Chinese music has been collaborated with other
yeah.
cultures. Is really comparatively is not so much.
Not so much.
Not so much. One thing I think the reason is maybe, you know, China has just opened up 30, 40 years ago.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
So for culture to rise, it can only come after economic rise.
Mm.
And it's just and now it's just the beginning. I think I'm looking forward to see more and quicker
yeah.
happening in the future, and also Chinese music, there's the nature of Chinese music may not have the same kind of nature as African music
mm-hmm.
or South American music, because first of all they are very rhythmic.
Yeah,
Chinese music is not so much in the rhythmic, mm. not so big on the rhythmic, but which it should be, actually. I think as the rhythms are almost come before melodies.
Yeah.
And mm. But somehow it's not so much emphasized in Chinese traditional concept. And for that reason, and it's not, and because for rock music or jazz, actually, or pop, jazz originally comes from Africa.
Yeah.
Blues.
Yes.
So that they already have that link.
Right.
And they're from the same family.
Right.
And then influence rock, influence pop. So it's very rhythm oriented
yeah.
music.
Yeah.
And Indian music, the melody, mm-hmm. and it has a lot of improvisation, so it can go freely with
yeah.
the Western.
We know Indian music is, next to jazz, probably the most highly developed improvisational art form in the world.
Yeah, very much so. Mm-hmm. And the scale.
Yeah.
The music scale for South American or Indian music, even Japanese music, it's closer actually to Western chromatic
uh-huh.
scale, because they have certain. But for Chinese music, it's very pentatonic oriented.
Yeah.
At least the
some of you're getting a little too musical for our audience, but that's a technical term, pentatonic. In fact, I should just mention this, because this might be interesting in terms of the stereotypes about Chinese music.
Mm-hmm.
Pentatonic means five tone scale.
Yes.
You know. So it's this simple kind of thing we associate with Chinese music, this simple five-note
yes.
scale, you know, da 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 da,
yeah.
this thing.
Yes. Da 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 da.
Right.
Yeah, that scale.
So is that the case? Is that true, that Chinese music is basically pentatonic or not?
It is basically pentatonic, yes.
Mm-hmm.
And there are other seven-tone scales, but they're not so much.
Used that much
right. in Chinese music.
Yeah. I don't mean to get too geeky here. I mean, we have two musicians here. I also do music. So the audience is going, what are they talking about?